Hey everybody, it's me, Armando Mero for the Armando Mero Show, and we're back playing Pokemon Colosseum for the Nintendo GameCube. And in the last episode, we took care of the people. And we captured, let's take a look. We took care of, we captured a Granbull and a Vibri, whatever, I don't really know. And, before we continue, I want to note that if you go into your PC, right, and go into your items, in the items where you withdraw deposit, you can actually withdraw one, one full restore. I did not know this, but you can actually do that. I guess from the beginning of the game. So that's actually really useful. No other Pokemon game does that. So, yeah. And if you're wondering where my time flutes are, well, I put them back in the PC. Because I'm not going to be using them. Not now. So, beyond these gates is, as you can clearly see, Cypher Pigeon Scrub. And if you did not, if you were unable to capture the Himmontop back at Relic Gate, at the Relic Forest, you're going to be facing him with level 41 Medichamp. He will not have any Shadow Pokemon, and his Why Not will be a Wobbuffet. And and his Pokemon are basically going to be the same. Now, those DNA samples that you picked up earlier, which you should have picked up earlier, are going to come in play right here. And like I did, you're going to have the DNA samples, but they're going to be different from mine. So it's going to be really smart of you to actually check what they are. Mine are Quilava, Entei, and Mischievous. Because this door is actually password. So, So it's going to be Entei, Mischievous, and Quilava. So let's battle him. Not once, not twice, but three times we meet. Do you recall who I am? I shall avenge my humiliation at the Relic Forest. Good on ya. So we start off the battle with, I think he's gonna send out his level 44 Graveler and his level 42 Wobbuffet. Now my, one of my subscribers and a person that I'm personally subscribed to, Zeg400, who's also doing his LP of Pokemon Colosseum, made a very interesting theory about Graveler. And the, comment that he actually put on one of my videos should be up in your screen now. He wrote something about the video, right? But he said about Graveler, because in my video, I questioned how Graveler can actually become, like, Golem? Or how his face, because here you can see that he still has, like, he has the face, but he doesn't have the head, the actual head, like, poking out. So his theory was that he has the flesh inside the rock, but then when he evolves, he just has the shell. And well, you see the comment, you can read it all. I'm not really gonna read the whole comment, but it's an actually nice theory, and I liked it. And Nintendo should really add that to the Pokédex. And here we have Maddie, who now is elevated to level 53. So, if you want to watch someone else's take on Pokemon Colosseum, go subscribe to Zeg400. Link is in the description bar, or wherever you see the annotation. I don't freaking know. And, Wow, I just went really quiet there, didn't I? And so, yeah, this battle should not be very hard at all. Wobbuffet's down before he can even do Mirror Coat, which Wobbuffet is famous for, especially in the anime, if I remember correctly. I haven't seen the anime in such a long time. I got disinterested I stopped watching after Advance, I think. I don't know. Alright, he took out Medichamp. My Athena could beat your Medichamp, I bet. Matters not, because AR can take you out pretty easily. But you do have some kick in you, so this should be interesting. And I also went to go buy some more hyper. I went to go buy hyper potions because I had the money. And because once you're here in the lab, you're gonna get a lot of money real quick. And yeah, this battle essentially is over because because I'm gonna do hyper beam, and Medichamp cannot survive a hyper beam. And AR can definitely survive a high jump kick. But can you survive? I'm beam? I don't know. I'm trying to say I'm firing my laser, but I failed. Fail. And there you go. Scrub was an easy person to beat. What, you have a headache? Take some aspirin. That works for me sometimes. And he's gone. And the next person that we will battle, as you should know by now, is the one, the only, Cypher. Admin. Is there anything over here? Oh yes, an item. 1 HP up. That's wonderful. Who am I gonna give that to? Who am I gonna give that to? Who has the lowest HP? The lowest HP. Athena has the lowest HP. I'll give it to you. Oh, I should really, 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 really. Can I say really, really anymore? Alright. Do I have. No, I don't have any more potions. I forgot. I sold them all. But I do have hyper potions. Because the next person we're gonna fight is, and I should really organize my Pokemon more, I'm gonna put Flaffy up first, is the one and only Cypher Admin, Ein. And again, we bring up my fellow LP'er, Zeg 400, who said that to pronounce his name correctly, it's Ein, as in like Einstein. I think that's what he said. So, let me bring up his voice.
Good. This disc has been scrubbed of all data. It's done. How did you get in here without my notice?
Ah, I see. You must be the much talk about Armando.
Little did I expect you to see here. I am Ein. I am George of the Shadow Pokemon Lab. No one must be allowed to interfere with our Shadow Pokemon plan. I will not allow it. Let me acquaint you with the power of my Shadow Pokemon. Go, Ateria. Go, Huntel. Show, Armando. What you are truly a mate of.
Alright, dude. Calm down. So, he sent out Altaria and the water thing. Kind of expected that. So, I'm gonna use Thunderbolt on Altaria because it's a dragon flying type. And for that, I think, and for the Huntel, it's probably electric water. So, I'm probably gonna do a mud shot. Thunderbolt, go! It did somewhat of good damage, I guess. If only I knew Thunder. Mudshot. Does somewhat of a good damage. I don't even know if I was correct if it's electric. Rain Dance. Thank you! That's gonna help me a lot, you know. It really is. But the reason why I think you put down electric is Rain Dance is because it is electric. Alright then. I know I did the Machot on Terrier and it was useless, but what was I gonna do anyways? Lantern. Ah, this is easy. This is too easy. And I know the Machot's gonna miss. I should have thought things a little bit more clearly. But this guy's just giving me easy access to almost everything. He gave me rain, and he gave me a Pokemon that I could use my Machot on. His Altaria is gone. So the next Pokemon he's gonna really bring out is either the Golbat or the Shadow Pokemon. Yep, Golbat. Easy takedown. Oh, he's gonna confuse Muddy. Oh, you bastard. But that's not stopping my Machot! Now your speed is lowered. Flaffy, take care of the Golbat. Muddy, you know, get rid of the nuisance. These two Pokemon are just a nuisance to everything that exists. Come on, Ein. I thought you would be much tougher than this. Oh, hello. The Shadow Raikou. Let's see if I have a better luck with Raikou than I did with Entei and Suicune. Hydro Pump. What are you really gonna do that against? Oh boy. Well. That was smart. Oh, great. And no Shadow Rush. Of course, and no Shadow Rush, but I'm wondering, is it going to be just a rusher? Is it going just going to be a rusher? It's just, I don't know. At least it's paralyzed. That's going to help me in the long run. Don't hit yourself. Don't. Ah, son of a gun. God damn it. Alright, let's see what I can do here. It's probably gonna hit AR. Yeah. Because it was meant to hit Muddy. Okay. Well. Thundershock should not do too much. Yeah, I knew that. Okay, that's good. Lantern is down, and that is his last normal Pokemon. So it's now just us. Thunder. Oh, great. That's fantastic. So now it's a question of who will last longer. I'm gonna confuse him, so just then makes my chances of capturing him even more higher. Confusion! Right, go! Thunder. Well, a good thing he's not really using Shadow Rush, although I did confuse him, so that may backfire him. Thunderbolt does a little too much. But I'm gonna start throwing my balls now. And hopefully And I doubt that's gonna work the first time around, but hey. You never know. Yep, I knew it. Wasn't expecting it to work. Alright, Thundershock is doing its job. If it hits itself, it's... No, it's not. It's gonna hit Umbreon. Oh, well, it didn't. Another Thundershock should bring it in the red. And then no more attacking. I'm just gonna throw the balls until I have no more balls. Wow, that sounded really weird. One. Two. Oh. Oh my god, I felt that. Okay. Don't hit yourself. Alright, okay. Oh, AR, you're really taking a beating, aren't you? Come on. Go! Come on, Raikou. Stay in the ball. It's your color. It matches your scheme. It really does. Oh my god. Why did I confuse it? Why did I confuse it? Why did I do that? Why? I'm so stupid. God, I'm so freaking stupid. Come on. One, two, three. Don't troll me. Oh, yes. Oh, thank you. Thank you, RCS.
This power, it defies belief.
Your struggle to get here was all in vain. The shadow Pokemon we produce have already been moved elsewhere. And that, of course, includes the ultimate shadow Pokemon I created for the boss.
Really? So the legendary shadow Pokemon aren't the ultimate shadow Pokemon? I would think that they were. Hey, what's up? It's me, Armando, in edit. Here's an interesting theory. Could he be talking about Shadow Lugia? There's food for thought.
Ha ha ha! Whoa, you have the same laugh as Dakim. That's creepy.
Alright, looky, shiny thingy. And we have one data ROM. We know what to do with that, do we? Don't we? I know what to do. We have to take this to Net. Down in the Yunda. That went more swimmingly than it ever did with Suicune or Entei. I'll tell you that much. What happened there? It just faded into black. Whatever. Alright, we're done with this joint. Let's get out of here. Oh, you hear that? We got an email. Email. Everybody has an email. Data Lab. Hi, this is Net. If you find any data at the Shadow Pokemon Lab, please bring it to me. How interesting. We just did. First, let's save. Okay, so we're going to the Yonder. And, yeah, we're going to the Yonder. Now that I said that, I really have to do that. Damn it. Okay, so Ned is over here. Let's go talk to him. Oh, Armando, how'd it go? Did you find any data? Indeed we did. Oh, now this looks interesting. Let's scope it out right away. Oh, this data ROM appears to contain a list of shadow Pokemon that have been made thus far. It looks like they wiped the data. Armando, please leave this with me. Like I have something better that I could do with it. I'll somehow try to receive the information from this data ROM, even if it means going over it a little by little. Armando, as soon as I discover anything, I'll email you. I think this was before texting was actually really popular. I would really love to see Nintendo take this game and, remake it in HD. So now that that's done. Let's go out of the under. You know, by the way, if you guys are wondering, I am doing this game 100%. So that means all the shadow Pokemon that we are going to capture are going to be purified 100%. I am going to do the mountain battle 100%. Oh, no, not that. What am I doing? I am going to be getting Ho-Oh. And I might even show off the Game Boy Advance compatibility thingy, because I have my Fire Red. Ooh, let's talk to this bloke. We finally finished work on that gigantic tower. Wow. Did it take time to build that thing or what? Oh, really? Let's take a look. Look at that! It's the final countdown. What the hell was that? Editor, we can't have that song in here. We might get sued. But yeah, look at this. We have this. That means we're really, really closer to the end of the game. If you can actually believe it. But you know what? Before we get even close to this place, I actually want to visit two people before we do this thing. And those people are Justy and Merkle B. So, in the next episode of Pokemon Colosseum, we're paying a visit to Justy. That's right. So I'll see you. Fennec City. Thank you.